हेलो हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। सो यस्टरडे वी स्टॉप्ड एट द फर्स्ट फाइव ईयर प्लान। डिड यू ऑल स्टडी योर पोर्शंस? सो व्हाट वाज द एम ऑफ फर्स्ट फाइव ईयर प्लान? मेनली द इरेडिकेशन ऑफ पॉवर्टी, इरेडिकेशन ऑफ पॉवर्टी। Then who drafted this? Who was the chairman of this drafting team? K.N. Raj. And the policy of development was hasten slowly. That means slow development was aimed by the Indian planners, because at that time there was utter poverty, so development could be occurred very slowly. And yesterday we also studied that for the first two decades or the first 20 years it was only possible, slow development was only possible, because fast rate of development might endanger democracy. Fast rate of development might endanger democracy, so the planners aimed slow development of India. So the main investment during the time of this first five-year plan, its period 1951-56, investment was mainly made in the field of agriculture, and as a part of this, many dams, the projects of dams and irrigation projects were there, and one such project was Bhakranangal Dam. Okay, so many its focus was on land reforms, land reforms. So what was the pattern of land distribution? Pattern of land distribution. Yesterday we studied that there was no equal land distribution, so it became necessary to change the pattern of land distribution. Land holding was in the hands of particular sections of society. So the planners aimed to raise the level of national income. Okay, because many problems were there. As basic level of spending was low, planners sought to push the savings up. So it became necessary to push up the savings of the country. Then the total capital stock was also very low compared to the total number of employable people. Then people's savings rose until the end of third five-year plan. Okay, so there was a rise in the savings of people. So yesterday I think you wrote these two questions, okay, Bombay plan and the first five-year plan, that you can send in our group, WhatsApp group. Then next we are moving to the second five-year plan. So in the first five-year plan, what factor, what aspect was given importance? Agriculture. But here heavy industries or the industrial sector was given importance. Industrial sector was given importance in the second five-year plan. And who was the head of the team? Who was the chairman of the team? P.C. Mahalanobis. Okay, P.C. Mahalanobis. So first five-year plan, Raj, okay, K.N. Raj. Then second five-year plan, P.C. Mahalanobis. And its aim was, the aim of second five-year plan was quick structural transformation. So their slow development, in the first five-year plan, they aimed, the planners aimed slow development of the country and agricultural sector was given importance, but here the aim was quick structural transformation. And in the Awadhi session of Congress, it is near Madras, a resolution was set by the Congress, and in this resolution the goal was declared as the socialist pattern of society. That means there is less inequality, socialist pattern of society. So second 5-year plan, period 1956-61. Okay, first 5-year plan 1951-56, second 5-year plan period 56-61. So here heavy industries were given importance, and the chairman of the drafting team was P.C. Mehalanobis, and its aim was quick structural transformation. Quick structural transformation was the aim of the second 5-year plan. Then in the Awadhi session of Congress, a resolution was passed by the Congress, and the goal of second 5-year plan was declared as the socialist pattern of society. So to protect the domestic industries, the government imposed tariffs on imports. So it was essential to develop the Indian industries, the domestic industries. So at that time, if there was foreign imports in large scale, that would affect the Indian industries. So what was the policy of the government? To protect the domestic industries, the government imposed tariffs on imports. Then both the public and private sectors were given importance, and heavy industries were given importance under the second 5-year plan. So heavy industries means electricity, railways, steel, machineries, communication, all these. So these were included in the public sector or under the government, under the control of the government. So heavy industries were also grown, and heavy industries were included in the public sector. That means under the control of the state. Okay, so this became a turning point in India's development. So we already covered that from the time of first five-year plan onwards, there was increase in the savings of the people. That means there was development. Development occurred as a result of these 5-year plans. So in the first 5-year plans, the planners gave importance to agricultural sector, and here in this second 5-year plan, they gave importance to the industrial sector, and drastic development was the aim of the government. And this period marked a turning point in India's development. So both under the second 5-year plan, both the public and the private sectors were given importance, but heavy industries, it was decided that heavy industries would be under the control of government. But there were several problems. Okay, India gave importance to the industrial sector, but technologically India was backward. So it became necessary to get technology from the outer world. Okay, so from global market we had to collect this technology. So India had to spend much for getting this technology. Okay, so India spent foreign exchange more, and more investment in the industry. When they invested much in the industrial sector, there was a possibility of food shortage. That means the agricultural sector was denied or neglected to some extent under the second 5-year plan. Okay, so there was a possibility of food shortage. So balancing this industry and agriculture became difficult. So under the second 5-year plan, there were several problems. When the planners gave much importance to industries, this sector, the agriculture sector, was denied to some extent. They couldn't maintain a balance between these two sectors, the industrial and the agriculture sectors. Okay, so technologically India was backward, so it became necessary to collect collect technology from the global market, and India had to spend much for getting this technology. And as there was more investment in the field of industry, there was the possibility of food shortage. So balancing industry and agriculture became difficult. So here some questions are written. In which ways did the second 5-year plan differ from the first one? In which ways did the second 5-year plan differ from the first one? Then state the main arguments in the debate that ensued between industrialization and agricultural development at the time of the second 5-year plan. Then the third 5-year plan, it was not much different from the second one. Okay, not much different from the second one, 61 to 66. Then main criticisms faced by this third 5-year plan, it was urban bias. So much importance was given to the towns, okay, urban areas. Then industry was given priority, and priority for heavy industries rather than agricultural industries. Actually, India needed priority for the agricultural industries because the main occupation of the Indians was agriculture. Okay, so it was essential to develop the agricultural industries, but under the third 5-year plan, priority was given for heavy industries. So there were several controversies regarding the second 5-year plan. Controversies regarding the second 5-year plan. So first controversy, agriculture versus industry. Whether this 5-year plan, whether this second 5-year plan gave importance to agriculture or whether it gave importance to industry. So it was here we have to study two controversies. First one, agriculture versus industry. Second one, public versus private sectors. Okay, so agriculture versus industry. Here in the second plan, emphasis was given on Indian industries, or emphasis was given to industries. So as a result of this importance to industries, the rural India had to suffer. Why? There was no importance to the agriculture sector. Even the agricultural industries were not given importance. So the second plan gave emphasis on industries, and as a result of this, rural India had to suffer. Then J.C. Kumarappa, he was a Gandhian economist, and he proposed emphasis on rural industrialization. Okay, so there were many criticisms towards this second five-year plan. One criticism, it gave much importance to the industrial sector, so the rural India had to suffer, or the agricultural field had to suffer. And the great economist of the time, J.C. Kumarappa, proposed emphasis on rural industrialization. And another leader, Congress leader, Chaudhary Charan Singh, he emphasized the need to keep agriculture at the center of planning for India. So Chaudhary Charan Singh was a Congress leader, and he emphasized the need to keep agriculture at the center of planning for India. Then, according to some others, to escape from the cycle of poverty, drastic increase in industrial production was essential. So people expressed different views. Okay, so according to a group of people, to escape from the cycle of poverty, drastic increase in industrial production was essential. Then agrarian strategy, to increase the production of food grains. So India needed the production of food grains. So according to these critics, an agrarian strategy would be followed by the planners. For what? To increase the production of food grains. Then land reforms laws were made. We already mentioned about that unequal distribution of land. So land reforms laws were made, and laws for distribution of resources from among the poor people. So laws were made, mainly land reforms laws, and laws for distribution of resources among the poor. Then proposals were also became essential for community development programs. So large sums were spent on irrigation projects. So many things were done by the planners. Land reforms laws were made, laws for distribution of resources among the poor was made, then proposals were made for community development programs, then large sums of money were spent on irrigation projects. But according to these critics, it became a failure. It was a failure. We cannot say this second five-year plan as a failure. Okay. So according to these critics, there was lack of proper implementation. Many laws were made, many development programs were made, even community development programs were made, but still it became a failure because of the lack of proper implementation. Laws were made, but no proper implementation. And the landowning class, we already mentioned that there were rich people who held this land. Okay, so this landowning class, they had social and political power, social and political influence. So they could influence the government. Okay, for what? For not implementing these laws. So landowning classes were socially and politically influential, and they utilized this situation. Then government spent much on agriculture, and even though the government spent much on agriculture, they couldn't solve the problem of rural poverty. So according to the critics. So according to the critics, land reforms laws were made and laws for distribution of resources were also made. Distribution of resources among the poor was also made, and there were proposals for community development programs. Then large sums were spent on irrigation projects. So all these were done, but not much development or not much this removal of poverty was there, and it was mainly because of the failure of lack of proper implementation. So what led to the failure of the second 5-year plan? Lack of proper implementation. And the landowning classes, they were very influential socially and politically. They were influential and powerful, so they could influence the government for the non-implementation of these laws. So even though the government spent much on agriculture, the problem of rural poverty couldn't be solved. So two models of development were there: capitalist and socialist. Socialist and capitalist models of development. So here comes the second controversy: public versus private. Okay, so while starting this chapter, I mentioned about the two models of development in front of the Indian planners, economists, were the capitalist system of or capitalist model of development of the US and the socialist model of development of the USSR. So two models of development were the capitalist system and the socialist system of development. But India didn't completely follow these two models of development. Okay, India didn't follow either this capitalist or this socialist model of development. Then you know about the difference between the capitalist and socialist model. In capitalist model of development or capitalist system, the production will be entirely under the control of private sector, private individuals or institutions. Then under the socialist system, production will be under the control of the state. So under the socialist system, there is no private property. Okay, so there were two models of development named as the capitalist system and the socialist system. India didn't follow these two systems of development. Okay, capitalist system means production, the control of production entirely under the private sector. Then the socialist system means production under the control of the state. Okay, under the socialist system, there is no private property. So what was the policy of India? Okay, I already mentioned India didn't follow these two. So India combined the elements of both these systems, both these models of development, and we can call it as the mixed economy. So India combined the elements of both the socialist and the capitalist models of development, and a new model of development was framed by India, and it is known as the mixed economy. So in the private sector, agriculture, trade and industries were included. Okay, then in public sector, heavy industries were included, like railway, electricity, etc. Okay, so under the private sector, agriculture, trade and industries were included. Then under the public sector, that means under the control of the government, heavy industries came. Okay, but industrial infrastructure was provided by the government. Industrial infrastructure was provided and the government regulated trade. Okay, then there was crucial intervention in agriculture. So even though the agriculture, trade and industries were included in the private sector, sometimes there was intervention of government in the field of agriculture. And who provided the industrial infrastructure? Sometimes the government provided this industrial infrastructure, and trade also not under the full control of the private sector. Who regulated or who controlled the trade? The government controlled the trade. So India combined the elements of both the capitalist and the socialist models of development, and it can be called as the mixed economy. Then in the private sector, agriculture, trade and industry were included. Then public sector, or under the control of the state, heavy industries came, like railways, and the government provided industrial infrastructure. Then trade was also regulated by the government, and there was crucial intervention of government in agriculture. So this mixed model also faced criticism. Okay, both from the left parties and the right parties, they criticize this model also. Okay, so the mixed model of development, or the mixed economy framed by our country, also faced criticism. Then who were the left and who were the right? Left parties were those in favor of the poor, downtrodden sections, and support government policies for the benefit of these sections. So the left parties are those who favors the poor, downtrodden sections of society and support the government policies for the benefit of these sections. Then the right believe, the parties, those who believe that free competition and market economy ensure progress and no government intervention in the economy. It is given in books, okay, in detail. So the right parties believe that free competition and market economy ensure progress and no government intervention in the economy. So the right parties, they gave much importance to the development of the private sector. Okay, so the left, they supported the control of government on all fields. So according to the critics, there was not much stimulus given to the private sector. So according to the critics, not much stimulus or not much importance was given to the private sector. If we take the case of public sector, its area was vast. Okay, and in the public sector, vested interests created hurdles or obstacles in giving licenses and permits for private investment. So according to the critics, there was no much importance given to the private sector in which 5-year plan? First, second or third? In the second 5-year plan. Okay, and the area of public sector is vast. But here vested interest created hurdles or obstacles in giving licenses and permits for private investment. Vested interest means many people, many influential people could influence the state, influence the government in giving licenses and permits for investment. So in the second 5-year plan and the third 5-year plan, there is no details of the third 5-year plan, and it is mentioned as it is not much different from the second 5-year plan. Then what were the criticisms faced by the third 5-year plan? It was urban base, then industry was given priority for heavy industries rather than agricultural industries. Then controversies, agriculture versus industry. Second plan, the second 5-year plan gave importance or emphasis on industries, and it would make a cause for the suffering of rural India. Then what was the attitude of J.C. Kumarappa, the Gandhian economist? He emphasized or he proposed emphasis on rural industrialization, not this heavy industries. Then Chaudhary Charan Singh, one Congress leader who later left this party, who later left the Congress party, emphasized the need to keep agriculture at the center of planning for India. Then according to some other critics, to escape from the cycle of poverty, drastic increase in industrial production became essential. So according to these people, drastic increase in industrial production was also essential for India. So there is not much importance for this. Then agrarian strategy, to increase the production of food grains. So according to these people, there would be a balance would be needed for this second 5-year plan. Both the agriculture and the industrial sector would be given equal importance. Then during the time of the second 5-year plan, land reforms laws were made and laws for distribution of resources among the poor. Then community for proposals were made for the community development programs. Then large amount was spent on irrigation projects. Then what was the problem? No proper implementation. So according to the critics, the second 5-year plan became a failure because of this non-implementation, or there was a lack of this proper implementation. Then landowning classes were socially and politically powerful. Socially and politically powerful, and the government spent much on agriculture, but India couldn't solve the problem of rural poverty. Then the private versus public, two models of development, capitalist and socialist. Capitalist model of development from the US and other European nations, then socialist model from the USSR. So India never followed or never imitated these two completely. Under the capitalist system, production will be under the control of private sector or private individuals or institutions. Okay. Then under the socialist model, production would be under the control of the state, and one important feature, there is no private property. Then India combined these two systems or two models of development and framed a new model of development called mixed economy. So private sector, agriculture, trade and industries were included. Then in public, heavy industries were included. Then even though these things, agriculture, trade and industry, came under the control of private sector, the government interfered in these matters. Also, industrial infrastructure were provided by the government. Then they regulated trade, the government regulated trade. Then there was a crucial intervention in agriculture. So mixed model was also faced criticism, the left, both from the left and the right. Right parties gave much importance to the private sector, then the left parties gave importance to the government, or the government sector or public sector. They worked for the poor people. Then according to the critics, there was not much stimulus given to the private sector. Public sector was vast, but vested interests created hurdles or obstacles in giving license and permits for private investment. Okay, that means many people influenced the government in giving these licenses and permits for investment. Anakha, hello. Anakha, can you give a brief description of this second 5-year plan? Second 5-year plan. Okay, start. First, its period. Period, that year. Okay. Then who drafted, who was the head of? Okay. Okay. I didn't hear that chairman of the second 5-year plan team. Chairman Mahalanobis, PC Mahalanobis. Okay. Then it's period. Okay, it's period. A 56-61. Okay. Today I am going to wind up. So tomorrow we can meet again. Okay. Bye. Take care.